We have the oven preheated to 350 degrees, and this is to bake for 45 minutes. So, now we're just gonna set the timer for 45 minutes, but you have to keep checking in on it to make sure that it's a good time. So at 45 minutes, take a toothpick and insert it, and make sure if the toothpick comes out clean, then they're done. If it comes out wet and all sticky, then that means just leave it in for a little bit, 5-10 minutes more. So I've set it for 45 minutes, and let's go. We'll see you back then. While we're waiting for our brownies to bake, we're gonna show you a desi twist on fiesta potatoes. And we need 1.5 pounds of russet potatoes cubed in 1-inch cubes, 3 tablespoons of tamarind powder or chaat masala, 3 teaspoons of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric or haldi, and 1/2 teaspoon of crushed pepper. And also a little bit, about 2 tablespoons of olive oil. So first we're gonna start out and we're gonna mix all of these spices together in a small bowl.
It's like a cool color show. You see all these colors just mixed together.
With Indian and Pakistani spices, there's always a very colorful array. And they're also very varietied, so there might be some things that you might not find in your average everyday pantry.
The aroma is really strong too. It gives it a very zesty
spicy
feel.
And zesty.
So that's should be
it. So it's a nice seasoning now, and you can see the crushed peppers and the haldi, turmeric. And so now we're just gonna add 2 tablespoons. It doesn't have to be exact measured, but it has to be portioned with your potatoes. So I'll just put about how much it seems right. I think that's good. And for this recipe, we're gonna preheat the oven for 450 degrees, and they're gonna bake for 45 minutes because potatoes generally take a longer time to bake. So we're just gonna, I'm gonna keep tossing it and you just keep adding, okay?
Like a salad, basically. So
yeah,
just sprinkle some over it lightly, and that's just turning. Sprinkle some more.
Sprinkle it all over. If you've ever been to like a fancy restaurant, then they have like solid salad tossers, like people who have like a spinning bowl and they like toss the salad like this.
Professionals, it's really cool.
Yeah, it's kind of hard, but make sure you don't like break any of the potatoes while you're doing this. And make sure it's like evenly coated.
And if you want the potatoes to have that nice fresh crunchiness, make sure to have them in a large bowl of cold water. That way,
like before you mix them in anything.
Give them that,
the nice crunch, and make sure that they're fresh. So
that's about all.
So we've added the last bit. And I'm just gonna toss them a little bit more to get an even coat. Did you grab that one for me?
Yeah,
it's a little clumsy. So as you can see, they're all evenly tossed right now, and they're nice and spicy, and you can smell how spicy they are. And you can always adjust the amount of spices that you add to your tastes, because if you like something more spicy, then you can always add more of spices. Or if you like things more like, I don't know, if you like it more Italian way, then you can always add like some Italian seasonings and make it your own way.
Rosemary or thyme, pepper.
Or oregano.
Oregano.
What a gum. So
Italian, Zoe, you're so Italian.
So we just need a tray, like a cookie sheet basically, and we're just gonna put a little bit of olive oil on the pan.
You might want like a paper towel to spread out evenly.
But of course there's always some in your potatoes, so it doesn't have to be too elaborately
spread, so we're just spreading it out. Careful, don't forget the corners. And so we're just gonna pour this.
Just dump it all out and then
basically
you can just
spread it out with your little spoons.
Yeah. Kind of even it out on the top so it's like leveled.
Because you want them to bake evenly, not so that half of them are overdone and half of them are still crunchy and
icky and so. Yeah.
So that's good.
New word for day. Yeah. Yeah. It's spelled, it should be spelled
N-Y-A-H.
Yeah.
So
some of our camera people are getting hungry.
So I think, so just to remind you again, it's 450 degrees Fahrenheit for 45 minutes, and since these brownies are on 350, we're gonna take this to another set
over
oven upstairs. We'll see you back when they're done. So now we're back, and we are back with our potatoes, and they're all done, and they smell delicious.
I want some.
So another thing that you can also try is after they're baked, then just take a lemon and just juice a little bit of it out, and it tastes great. And you can smell the spiciness of it, and it smells great.
Hurry up,
great.
Finish. I want to eat. Hurry.
The caramel brownies are out of the oven too. And we'll get those going in a second, and we're gonna make caramel brownie sundaes, which is one great way to make it, to eat them in an even more delicious way, because everyone loves ice cream, and on top of that, brownies with chocolate, and they're gonna be just great, and I can't wait to show you. So we're just gonna use a spatula and a fork, and carefully just, they might be still a little soft,
fragile-ish,
and yeah,
very, very, very careful.
So you wanna kill the brownie. I'm gonna try not to.
This is very, very
surgical work.
Surgically also means with precise skill. I learned this.
In English, yes.
Oh, I have a. Ah, they smell really, really, really good.
I can't wait to eat them. Right. And all the caramel has melted and it has become all oozy and goozy, and it tastes, just looks so good.
So good to eat.
So yummy. So I'm gonna scoop out some, like a scoop or two of vanilla ice cream.
Yummy, yummy vanilla. Ooh, that's really, really like creamy.
And it's gonna be perfect because the brownies are still warm and the ice cream is really cold. So it's gonna make a perfect sundae of hot and cold. As I was saying before, a sundae is just one way to enjoy brownies. You could have them as a late midnight snack or, yeah. Do you get that?
It's stuck.
No, ice cream. Just get it.
I don't wanna eat it.
Okay, so. So let me just scoop out a nice big scoop of ice cream, and can I get the spoon? And just aid it to come out. And as I was saying before, the hot and cold really go well together, the Katy Perry song. And
am I singing this?
No.
No.
So
just sing two.
And
it's a lot.
Caramel and chocolate. Awesome, with the vanilla ice cream.
Super yummy.
And
we have
some fudge sauce, which we're gonna drizzle over. This looks so perfect, doesn't it? They look delicious. And now we have our perfect brownies and vanilla ice cream sundaes, and they look so good.
You're missing out. You're like, seriously? Seriously, there's like no words to explain it. They're that good.
The brownies are chewy and gooey, and they taste so good with the vanilla ice cream and the chocolate syrup.
You just have to try it.
Mm-hmm. They're absolutely amazing. And back to the potatoes. As you can see, they're out of the oven, and they are also look delicious. We told you earlier that it would bake for 45 minutes, but that depends on the type of potato you use. We use russet potatoes, and that took actually about 30 minutes. But if you were to use a small red potato, then it would be 45 minutes. It would be take a longer time. So it all depends on the variety of the potatoes that you use. And so as these are done, and they also look amazing. And they smell amazing too. Very flavorful and smelly in a good way.
Bon appetit.
Hot and spicy, and I love all potatoes to begin with, but these are really flavorful and spicy, and especially good for people enjoying a spicy, more diverse cultural sort of taste. Really great. I really wish that you could be here and try all these great recipes. So you gotta try them at home. Yes, thanks for reminding me. Yes, we'd like to thank all of our viewers for sending us lots of emails. And to our newer viewers, then we would like to give you our information so that you can keep sending us your information. So get a pen and pencil out and a piece of paper and write down our email, which is zohah@ayantv.com. zohah@ayantv.com. Thank you. Just hurts me more when we're apart.